Hi viewers, in this video we are going to see about the microprocessor architecture. In microprocessor architecture, we are going to see about the CPU, the memory and the address. Okay, fine. So normally you will know what is a computer and what is a microcontroller. Okay, so microprocessor, microcomputer, or different components where microcomputer is a programmable machine in which the computer will do different types of instructions. It will be performed whatever the information what we are going to give. Okay, it will respond for the set of instructions what we are going to give, and inside it consists of the CPU, input devices and the memory, right? So the processor, microprocessor is a very important one where it does the operations of the for the requirements. That is just like arithmetic logic units, and there is a arithmetic mathematical calculations and the logic decision can be taken in the microprocessor, and it will send it to the signal for the controlling the devices. Okay, the microprocessors will get the information and it will store with the help of our registers, and then it process, it will send to the devices. Okay, this is a process which is going to be done in the microprocessor, and the microcomputer is having the microprocessor as one of the unit over there. It connects with the input and output devices, and it will send the datas. It will take and it will get the information from the input output devices. It will store in a memory, and then it sends the datas after processing. All right. So here there are the thing what we are going to see is input devices, memory, and output devices. Or it is connected, and CPU is the main thing. Microprocessor is the one which is a part of the microcomputer. Okay, so here the datas and from the devices, input devices, and it will send it to the memory first, and it will get stored later when it is needed processing. The data will be taken back to the microprocessor, and it is getting processed again. It will be stored over here for the permanently thing, and it shows the output devices the information also. So either it may be a monitor or keyboard or something, monitor or any other devices, it can send a printer and all. So this is the microcomputer will do, and a microprocessor, it has what is that processor, the CPU we will say. It consists of arithmetic logic unit and registers and control unit. So the process, whatever it is taken from the memory, it goes to the registers, temporary registers, and then it goes to arithmetic logic units where the logics process can be done and calculation for done. Then it sends the signal to the controller unit, so for controlling the operations. Okay, so this is what the microprocessor, how it is functioning, how what is the use here. Let me see the components of the elements of the microprocessor here. So input and output devices, it is normally the keyboard, joysticks or sensors, whatever it is, and the output devices are the monitor, printer, everything, display, everything is the output. So that information from the input and output, the data processing, how the information has to process from the input to this process, and from the processor to output is through some set of wires. We call it as bus. Now let me see that bus here, and then memories. So memory is the one where it is getting stored, the information getting stored over here. So let me see one by one here. What is the ALU? Okay, ALU is the arithmetic logic unit where arithmetic operations like add, subtractions, so calculation parts, whatever we are going to do, that is taken care of by the ALU, as well as the logical information. Suppose one information, if both the switch are on, then power has to it has to supply the power. And if at least only one switch is on, then it can supply. So like that, some information and or not, these are all the logic decision that can be taken for any operations. So that can be done with the help of the arithmetic logic units. And registers array or the storage data during the execution of program. So whenever we are giving, already whatever given the information, it will be stored, and it now before it processing, that registers will help to store that temporarily. It will take and it will make the information to wait for us, and it will send to the process, return back, and it get into save the process, save the data like that. So control unit, it provides the timing and control signals. It controls the flow of data. So how much fast it has to go and how much fast it has to come after the process or for sending the process, all the things, the control unit will help. And the microprocessor is one of the component in the microcomputer, right? So memory, second ALU we have seen, and what is the memory we have seen, we are coming over here. So there are two types of memory. Or the first memory, in the sense it is used to store the information what is in the form of binaries. Okay, so when we are adding two numbers, 2 plus 3, if you are giving an input, this information first 2 will be getting stored in terms of binary, and 3 will be getting stored in the terms of binary, the plus will be stored. So that all the things is getting, we need a place where it is to be stored before going for the process. So here there are two things out there. It is used to store the programs, do not need any alterations. Read only memory is over memory where there is no alteration, just directly it will store as it is. Random access memory is where we can store the program that can read and edit it. We can alter the program data. So that is a two important memory areas. And we will come for peripheral devices, that is the input and output devices. So input, normally the information communications is needed. A microprocessor is just a machine. It is used for taking the logical decisions and the mathematical calculations, but how information has to be passed to it and how the information we can take it from that. So that we need some devices, that is, which is connected to the outside world. We will call as input devices and output devices. So in input devices, we can give the information to the devices what to be done. So and output, we can take back after the process what actions to be taken, that it will send the signals to the monitor, either to the monitor or to the printer and some output devices. So this is what input and output devices. And how these can be done, okay, how the information is taken to the system and it can taken back from the system is called bus. So a bus is a communication path between the microprocessor and the peripherals, a group of wires we call it the bus, which carries the information, the binaries in that, which called as a bits. Okay, so it carries the bits and it takes, it stores, it sends everything. So this is the bus system, bus. So this is all the important points over there in the microprocessor structure. And what are the things it will do? Okay, fetch, decode and execute, these are the three important sequence it will do. So executing the program, to execute the program, it needs to get the instructions from the memory. First of all, to get for instructions for the memory, we are giving the informations and that is already it is stored in the memory. So to program that or to execute the program, the instruction, it takes the, reads the information from the memory, and then it converts to the machine language. And whatever it is needed, then it is executing the program. There is fetch, decode and executing is there. So whatever we are giving, it will be getting stored in the memory and then it will convert into decode, it is getting binary decodes into its own language, then it will be done. So execution process will be there. This is what how the microprocessor structure is using. So ALU, memory, and the system bus are very important over there in this. So next we will see about the data register and program counters, what it is there. So as of now, this will be over, right? Thank you.